Let's explore some interesting applications of the simple concept ratios to some tricky and interesting problems. Two jars each contain the same number of marbles, and every marble is either blue or green. In jar 1, the ratio of blue to green marbles is 9 to 1. So they both have the same number of marbles. Let's say x marbles. Jar 1, x marbles. Jar 2, also x marbles because they have the same number. So jar 1, ratio blue to green is 9 to 1. So blue is 9 tenths x, green is 1 tenths x. Right? Similarly, jar 2, blue to green, 8 to 1, which means 8 ninths x and 1 ninths x, because the total fraction of each must both, the sum must be equal to x in both cases. So there's 95, let's write this in green, 1 ninths x. So there's 95 green marbles in all. 1 tenths x plus 1 ninths x is 95. How many more blue marbles are in jar 1 than jar 2? Okay, so we've got a simple equation here. Let's multiply by 90 to get rid of all these fractions. 90 times the whole thing times 90. This becomes 9x plus 10x equals 95 times 90. And a common mistake is to try and multiply it out immediately. Wait, things will often cancel like they are going to now. 19x is 95 times 90. X is 5 times 90, 450. Because 95 is 5 times 19, right? Okay. But we're asked to find how many more blue marbles in jar 1 than jar 2. That's 9 tenths x minus 8 ninths x, which is 9 tenths times 450. Minus 8 ninths times 450. That is 45 times 9. 45 times 9 is going to be equal to, we can just do 9 squared times 5. So 45 times 9 is just 405. And 8 ninths times 450 is just 8 times 50. Let's move out of the way. 8 ninths times 450 is just 8 times 50. That's 400. Answer? It's just going to be equal to 5. Okay, so 5 is the answer to this problem. Let's now explore a more interesting problem. A little bit more interesting. There are 994 students in Omega Middle School. 2/7 are in 6th grade, 2/7 are in 7th grade, and 3/7 of them are in 8th grade. And 1/4 of the 6th graders are interested in math. 3/4 of the 7th graders are interested in math. And half of the 8th graders are interested in math. Of the students who are interested in math, 5/7 will take the AMC8 competition this year. How many students will take the AMC8 from Omega Middle School? Okay, so, let's see, so 994 students, 2/7 are in 6th grade. 2/7 times 994. Okay, so let's do this. Oh, we can divide this out and do some computation like that. But 994 is a cool trick I covered in my divisibility videos. 994, notice how it's 980 plus 14. So this is also the same thing as 2/7 of 980 plus 2/7 of 14. And 2/7 of 980, well, we know 980 divided by 7 is just, we know 98 is 14 times 7. So 980 divided by 7 is 140. So 2/7 of 980 is just 2 times that, 280. Plus 2/7 of 14, that's just 4. So 284. 6th graders. Cool. Now, how many 7th graders? That's also going to be 2/7 of 994, which is also 284. Now, what about three? What about eighth graders? So this is sixth, seventh, eighth. 3/7 are eighth graders. So 3/7 times 994. Remember how 994 was 980 plus 14. So we can rewrite it like that. And this gives 3/7 times 980, that's 420. 3/7 times 14, that's 42 divided by 7, 6. 426 eighth graders. Okay, so these are the total amount. Now in red, we'll see the amounts that are actually interested in math. Okay, let's see. So, 1/4 of the sixth graders are interested in math. 1/4 times 284, that's 71. Seventh graders, 3/4 of them are interested in math. 3/4 times 284, that's 71 times 3. That's 213. Right? Okay, now eighth graders, half are interested in math, right? Half. Half times 426, that's 213 as well. Wow. Same number. Okay, and of the all the students who are interested in math, 5/7 are going to take the AMC 8. So how many are there? Well, first of all, total interested in math is just 71 plus 213 plus 213. And we can just add this up, 71 plus 426, that's 497. 5/7 of them are going to take the AMC 8. 5/7 times 497, and another cool trick, like the same trick from earlier, we split up 5 497 into 490 and 7. This gives 5/7 times 490. 490 divided by 7 is 70. 70 times 5, 350. 5/7 times 7, well, the 7s just cancel, just 5. So our answer is just 355. We just work through the ratios and we get our answer. Let's try a slightly more tricky problem this time. This one is going to require some ingenuity. Okay, Steph scored 15 baskets out of 20 attempts in the first half, as you can see over here, and 10 baskets out of 10 in the second half. Candace took 12 attempts in the first half, 18 in the second, and in each half, Steph scored a higher percentage of baskets. However, at the end, they ended with the same overall percentage. Okay, how many more baskets does Candace score in the second half than in the first half? Okay, this is interesting. So, to do this, let's see. So, Steph is 15 out of 20, which is 75%. So Candace must be less than 75%. It has to be less than 75% or it won't satisfy the condition. So what is 75% of Candace's attempts? 12. 75% is 3/4, so that's 9. So if Candace were to make 9 out of 12, that would be 75%. But Steph scored a higher percentage in each half. So it has to be less than 9. So this can be 8. It's going to be less than 9. So let's just say it can be anything from 1 to 8 or even 0 for that matter. These are all the possibilities. So let's write that down here. So this can be anything that's 8 or less. Right? Now, what about in the second half? Well, Steph's percentage is 100%. So anything less than 100% for Candace is acceptable. It can be 18. 18 out of 18, that's 100%. It needs to be less. So anything less than 100% is good. 17, 16, 15, so on. But surprisingly, they ended with the same overall percentage. Okay, so what's Steph overall percentage? 25 by 30. That's the overall. I'm not going to convert it to a percent because that would just make it a nightmare with fractions and or repeating decimals. And what's Candace's overall percentage? Whatever, over 30. Okay, so to end up with the same overall percentage, Candace, this number must also be 25. So the sum of these two numbers, attempts make in both halves, must be 25. Let's look closely here. So the first half for Candace can be 8 or less, second half is 17 or less, and the sum must be 25. Aha! They both must be the highest possibility, so 8 and 17, to get the total number of baskets to be 25. Anything less, too little. So it has to be 8 and 17. So now we can fill in this right here. 8 and 17. But the question asks, how many more baskets did Candace score in the second than the first? That's 17 minus 8, 9. So 9 is our answer. A really cool problem. The key idea, first, look at the possibility for the first half, the possibilities for Candace. Then, same thing for the second half. Then look at the overall percentage and see that total baskets must be 25, and this requires Candace to have scored the maximum number of baskets possible, and we get 8 and 17, giving us 9. Okay, now we're going to move on to rate and work. These types of problems, we have workers working in a given time amount at a given rate, and we have to calculate things out. And this is the application of ratios and proportions, which we'll be exploring next time. Click on it by clicking right over there.